Right, I'm making another video, and the CD has arrived. I'm doing Vinnie Vincent's Invasion, All Systems Go. This is a great album. I really like this. And I never had it back in the day. I probably listened to it again maybe about 20 years ago. I downloaded it and I thought, oh, you know, I've been sort of missing out. The Vinnie Vincent Invasion, you had Bobby Rock on drums, you had Mark Slaughter singing, Vinnie Vincent on guitar, and Dana Strum on bass. Mark Slaughter and Dana Strum went on to start Slaughter after the band sort of imploded. And on this album there's some really good tracks. And you know, Vinnie Vincent, you know, I think he's got a bit of a bad rep. There's a lot of stories about him. You know, I've read this story of when Kiss was on tour and they went to somewhere like Finland, and they went to the gig, and there was a pot of beef stew, and they all sat round to have this pot of beef stew before the gig. Vinnie Vincent tried a bit out the ladle and then chucked the ladle into the pot, therefore contaminating the stew for everybody else. But having heard that story, I think it sounds a bit far-fetched, because I'd imagine Kiss would be staying in five-star hotels. But anyway, I'm going to start with my first track off here, which is Burn. That's my first track. The stories, you know, about Vinnie Vincent. I've been on the internet today and I've been looking at this Dana Strum, the bass player, and he seems like a really decent guy. He's the guy that got Ozzy Osbourne his guitar player. So he got Ozzy Osbourne, Randy Rhodes. He suggested Randy Rhodes as Ozzy Osbourne's guitar player. But he was saying this story about Vinnie Vincent, and he said they were in the studio, and Vinnie Vincent was having a lot of trouble with his guitar. I think his guitar had a Floyd Rose trem, and he couldn't tune his guitar because he didn't have any Allen keys, and the top nuts were locked. And he was getting more and more pissed off with the guitar, and he was talking to it, going, "Oh, you bitch," sort of thing. And he threw his guitar down on the floor of the recording studio, got his cock out, pissed on the guitar, and pissed on the floor, and then left. So this is the kind of thing, you know, you imagine if you're in a band and the lead guitar player's doing that, you know, you wouldn't be very happy, would you? Right, so the next track I'm going to do Love Kills, which I think is... I haven't got my glasses on, so I'm struggling to read this, but I think it's track three, I think. Now, Love Kills is from, I think it's from Nightmare on Elm Street 6, I think it was. I remember going when I was, I don't know, 17, 18 maybe, something like that, to go and watch it. It was a double matinee performance in Peterborough with my mates, quite late at night, and it was the film Shocker, which has got, that's got a heavy metal soundtrack. There's quite a few Kiss songs on that. And then Nightmare on Elm Street. I'm sure it's Nightmare on Elm Street 6. And I really love this. This Love Kills. It's just great. It's just a great song. You know, it proves what a genius, Vinnie Vincent is. So let's go to that. And I'm sure it's track 3. I'll try and crank it up a bit. Vincent seems to have like disappeared. He seems to have like disappeared for sort of 20, 30 years, and then recently he's reappeared as a woman. He's had a sex change, and I think really with what's gone on in his life, Netflix ought to go, well, I'll tell you what we'll do, make a film about Vinnie Vincent, because he's had such a sort of wild life sort of thing. And like, I think like now, you know, like I said, everybody gives him an hard time. But when you sort of listen to him, I mean, I know he's probably a bit loony, but you know, sort of fair play to him. If he wanted to be out of the spotlight and he wanted to do his own thing, have a sex change and become a woman, I think it's fair enough. And like, when you look at him now, you know, imagine if they were making a film, they'd get Julia Roberts in to play him now, sort of thing. And you think, like, going on a date with Vinnie Vincent, he's probably, his food manners wouldn't be very good at the restaurant, but you know, if you got invited back to his flat sort of thing, and he was like, oh, you know, do you want to get in bed, you'd be like, well, what about your guitar collection, can I have a go on your carbon flying V? That'd be all right, wouldn't it? So what I'm gonna do now, this is me last song off here, this is my absolute favorite song, and this video, I've got a little message on it and on here for my son Sebastian. Now, if you're watching this video in 20 years' time, and we're after some funeral music, this is Vinnie Vincent, That Time of Year. This song is what I'd like to be played at my funeral. This is one of the songs I'd like to be played at my funeral. So this is track 7. This is That Time of Year. This is me, you know, in my top 3 favourite songs. So we'll skip to that.
Thank you.
Right, so that's all I'm doing. This that was Vinnie Vincent's Invasions, all systems go. Definitely in the top 20 list of hair metal albums. Definitely worth a listen. And I think the next album I'm doing is Bon Jovi, Slippery When Wet. Okay, cheers for now. Bye.